Namaskar and welcome to this special videocast of Sikkim Chronicle. Education is the cornerstone of every child's life, and the importance of guidance and importance of education is of course one of the prime aspects of any individual's career. And today with me is Ma'am Karma Doma Gyatso, Principal of Khang, and Mr. Bhupendra Gurung, who is the founder of the Accelerator Academy. How important is guidance when it comes to children in a very early stage?
Okay, going back to 2010, since then, I have actually never looked into the idea of children going for extra classes or tuition for that matter after our classes in 10. But lately, I've come to realize that the parents are always in a dilemma as to where to send their child for the next two months, which is very crucial. A child has to remain in touch with his books. And knowing the child of today, they are so inclined to mobile, their TV. They prefer to spend their time more playing games on their mobile and spend time on TV, which will indirectly affect their studies. They lose out on their study hours. And taking all this into consideration, this year I have requested Mr. Bhupendra Gurung, who is also an ex-student of Khang School. He is running a center known as Accelerator. I have requested him to make a special package for Khang School, and we are starting this as a pilot project. He will be taking students for all the five main subjects. Now, I am yet to see the feedback of this. I had a meeting today with the parents, and in fact, they were very happy that I have taken a load off their back. They were on a fix as to where to send the children. So putting this in front of them, it was up to them. It was not mandatory for them to put the child inside this or not. It's not that I strongly suggest, but it is something that, you know, a child has to be given. A child has to be taught for 2 months. A capsule has to be given to them on what is going to come in the board and what not. So I have requested Bhupendra to look into this, and I'm sure the next we get is a very good feedback, and I'm sure that my children will do very well, and I'm looking forward to this. Thank you.
My question for you is that, have you, since you run a coaching academy, have you noticed parents, coming to you in a hurdle, and then just asking for some suggestion, in the last moment, just before the exams are approaching? So how do you deal with parents and guardians in such a situation?
Well, yes, there are occasions where parents at the last moment, they are very nervous, and especially when the examination dates are very close by, they panic even more than the students actually. So yeah, they come to us and they ask us whether, because normally what happens is winter coaching session, they gets over by the last week of February, and then the examination begins by the first week of March. And then you have a lot of, gaps between every subject. For example, if English is the first exam, then let's say your SST is after a week or after 5 days. Then you have mathematics after a gap of 10 days, So what we do, Accelerator, what we do is we encourage the parents and then the students to continue sending their kids during those gap days as well, for which we have no financial obligations from the parents. That is absolutely free of cost from us, provided they've actually done their winter coaching from us during the winter coaching phase. So we do that. We keep such sessions. I personally attend to the students for their tough subjects like mathematics or science, for that sake. There are our faculties are also very dedicated, and they would love to contribute for the upliftment and the welfare of the students whenever they are asked for. See, we handle that quite properly, I believe, and this is something which I'm sure everybody should be doing, because immediately after the coaching is over, then we feel that the job of a coaching center is done. But the peak hour of nervousness hits when the board examination begins. So if we continue to give such services to the students and then the parents, I think they would love to have somebody who can guide them during those examination days as well.
and then we are doing that. Thank you.
Internet is playing a huge role these days. So how important is for parents, teachers, students, and everyone, you know, to counsel oneself first, you know, and to be updated with things before, you know, approaching an institute or, you know, a coaching academy?
Very important. Actually, thinking back to all the events that have taken place, I think it's very important to counsel the parents first. The parents need to understand that it is not, you know, necessary to impose what they want on the child. Like suppose you want your child to be a doctor and his mental ability is not so much. So you must learn to give the freedom to the child. Let him grow as he is, not impose his whims and fancies on the child. So it is very important for the inner child to grow. This is what I would like to request all the parents to do, because basically a child will grow only if he is given the freedom to do what he wants actually, to study what he wants, to become what he wants to do. Okay?
What does your experience say in this topic?
The expression of freedom and obviously utilizing your liberty to the fullest scale where constructive activities are engaged with the students is such an important aspect of the growth of a child. Liberty, when we give students liberty of doing things on their own, we also tend to also analyze the potential of that student of conducting himself on a normal scale or on a scale where, you know, because you're always protected by your parents, you're always surrounded by your elders all the time. So that the expression of freedom is absolutely important.
There's so many institutes and coaching academies which claims to, you know, give 100% results and all those things. So how to filter and scan, you know, which one is giving you a holistic kind of knowledge and which one is just like trying to play around?
See, statistics and figures are absolutely important in revealing your success and also developing your rapport with your audience. But having said that, you know, the most easiest way to evaluate the conduct of a coaching is to go and then speak to the main person who's responsible for organizing such sessions. Because once you speak to that person and also understand the depth of his or her motive behind the conduct of the sessions during winter coaching, you'll be very easily seeing yourself in a comfortable position to decide whether this person really will deliver this thing or not. Because, see, promotions, branding, marketing, you say so many things, but not 100% is delivered, you know. And you're coming back to the question of those coaching institutes who actually look forward to admit the fact that they produce 100% result might be true or may not be true. We don't know about that. Because normally what happens in place like Kota, I'll just give you a small example. There are some very leading coaching institutes over there where there are more than 25,000 students studying in such coaching institutes. So that's even bigger than a university. What they normally do is they normally tend to take first rank holder students, even if they're not studying in their coaching, they tend to do an agreement with the student saying them, these are the final financial obligations that we will bear for your say of saying that you have studied from my coaching institute. So it's a very big industry there. It's a 300 crore industry in Kota where everybody wants to get hold of first rank candidates and they want to bring them under their banner. And obviously the kids are being paid. I'm sure you must have heard this news about a couple of years back. One guy was awarded a very luxury car. It was a Mercedes or a BMW. A student who actually scored the highest marks received that. So it's that kind of thing. I'm sure it's not applicable here in Sikkim, but I believe the parents will have to be very, very smart and understand the content of the session, the quality of the faculty members, the format of your routine of your the deliverables. These are all very important thing, and it's also very important that you talk to the main person of the organization, also interact with the faculty. If you'd like to speak with the ex-students who have actually passed out from that coaching institute, you can do that as well. These are things that will definitely help you. And then if you've done your homework well, I think there should be no confusion.
Ma'am, in view of all the things that he just said about the blatant, you know, commercialization, what is your one advice to parents?
Yes. I think the parents should concentrate on where they're putting their child and into which institution and the background. They should check the background and not just follow the instinct of the children. The school is doing what best that we can for the child. So please do think and put your child wherever you think best. Do your homework well and I'm sure your child will score. Thank you.
On that beautiful note, I'd like to cut short this podcast. Thank you so much, both of you, for joining us here in Sikkim Chronicle. I hope this is very useful for all the parents. Keep following Sikkim Chronicle for all the updates.